Hey everybody, welcome to this tutorial dedicated to SolidWorks, one of the most powerful CAD platforms for technical drawings and advanced three-dimensional projects. In this video, we focus on SolidWorks 3D CAD for Windows, and we share with you all you need to know to get started. Let's open SolidWorks. This shows the welcome screen where you can pick any recent document to start from, or create a new project from the list above. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to make a part and an assembly project. Let's start with the part project. This lets you draw 2D sketches or create any 3D component with a specific material. These components will be later combined with others for a more complex 3D object. The new part project opens completely empty. You get the command manager at the top with several drawing tools and options we will see, and several panels on the left with other options. If any panel is missing, you can reopen it by going to the View tab and then to Toolbars. Before starting, set the options of SolidWorks and of your project. At the top, click next to the gear icon and head to Options. You have two tabs here. On System Options, you set all the options for the software, such as the general interface color. On Document Properties, you set the options for the current project only. For example, under Units, you set the measurement units to use. And under Dimensions, you set how to show those measurements. Now, let's start drawing in 2D. Head to the Sketch tab in the top left corner to see the list of all the tools you can use in a 2D environment. Let's start drawing a line with the Line tool. The first time you drop a sketch, SolidWorks asks you to choose a plane as reference, either directly on the preview or from the quick selection list in the top left corner. To draw on the ground plane, just select the top plane as reference. With a line tool, click on the preview to drop consecutive segments. Use the Escape key to finish drawing and press Enter to enable the tool again and continue. If you close the shape, this will be filled automatically in blue color. Use Ctrl and Z to undo any drawing. Enable the Spline tool to draw a spline by clicking on the preview and double-clicking to finish the curve. Use the Arc tool to drop an arc by fixing the center point, the radius, and then the arc length. Enable the Circle or the Ellipse tool to drop a circle or an ellipse by fixing two or three points on the preview. Use the Rectangle or the Polygon tool to drop a regular shape. Click once for the center and another point to fix the circumference radius on which the polygon is drawn. Each tool has a down arrow showing several ways to draw the same object. For example, you can change how to draw an arc by dropping three points. From the Property Manager panel on the left, you can also adjust several parameters, such as the circumference to be used or the total number of sides. Each 2D object you draw in the preview is called sketch, made by entities such as curves, single segments, or the sides of a polygon. While you draw, SolidWorks provides several helpful tools. It displays live measurements of the object and shows when your lines or angles are parallel to a reference axis. It also shows dashed guidelines to meet perpendicular, horizontal directions, or others to match key points of a shape. You can also make relations between the current drawing and another object, such as crossing a point, being tangent to a curve, or perpendicular to a side. These relations are shown in yellow while drawing, and in green once dropped. There are many different relations you can apply to one or multiple objects. Check the video description for more details on these. You'll also get snapping to object's key points to draw quickly. You can avoid this by holding down the Control key. To zoom in or out, use your mouse wheel and move your cursor where you want to zoom. Hold Control and use your arrow keys to pan around the area. All your drawings are part of a single sketch layer called Sketch 1, shown under the Feature Manager Design tree on the left. This appears in blue in the preview because it is currently being edited. Press Ctrl and B to apply the current drawings and exit from the editing mode. Once approved, you can select the sketch layer from the left and edit it entirely on the preview. Use the arrows to move the sketch or drag the nodes to scale it. If these options do not appear, make sure you are not inside any other sketch in progress
and use the Escape key to disable any tool you are using.
To delete an entire sketch, select it, right-click on it, and go to Delete. To edit the sketch layer again, simply double-click on it on the preview. To make an independent sketch layer, exit the current sketch, enable any tool, select the plane you want, and then draw on the preview. This new drawing becomes part of a new sketch layer, completely independent from the previous one. From the Feature Manager design tree, you can see the new sketch layer with a traffic light symbol, meaning that this layer is being edited. While you are inside a sketch, if you have no tools enabled, you can click on any node or path to select it and adjust it with the Property Manager panel on the left. Set the total length, inclination, or position using the X and Y coordinates. Select any entity and use Ctrl and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste it. The cut-paste allows you to separate an entity from the others, while you can cut any object to remove it quickly. Click on any node or side to edit the shape of the sketch. This does not break the existing relation already defined. To remove a relation, go to the Property Manager panel on the left, head on Existing Relations, and select the relation to delete, shown in pink on the preview. Once the relation is removed, you can edit the polygon shape freely as you like. When you select an object, a dialog box appears with several options. Use Make Horizontal or Make Vertical to make a side parallel to the main axis. This also creates a relation, as shown here. Use Make Fixed to lock the selected entity so you cannot change its shape. Enable the Smart Dimensions tool to add annotations to sides, radii, and more. Just click and drag from any side to measure it and apply before moving to the next. You can also type the correct length directly inside the box, in millimeters or in other units you prefer. These values are saved even if you later modify shapes. You can also select any entity and apply any of the 2D tools available at the top within the Sketch tab. For example, use Move Entities to move an entire entity through the panel on the left, typing the values, and pressing Enter to apply. This is very useful to move an entity without distorting its shape. Right-click and go to OK to apply, or use the green check mark on the far right. To apply tools to multiple entities, first select all of them. Click and drag to create a selection area. At this point, enable the tool, for example, to rotate entities. Define the center of rotation and the degrees to apply. Check the entity selected for rotation on the left, and review any relations listed. Now, let's see how to draw in 3D. To do this, you have to prepare 2D and 3D sketches that you will use to build 3D objects. As long as you use the Sketch button, your 2D sketches always lay on a plane. To draw sketches in a 3D environment, switch to 3D Sketch in the top left corner. If you do not see this button, make sure you have exited any sketch currently being edited. At this point, you can use the drawing tools we have already seen for 2D sketches. In a 3D environment, press the spacebar key to open the orientation window and select the point of view or plane you want to keep while drawing. For example, let's choose this point of view and draw inside. The 3D sketch will lay on the 2D plane selected. To get a full preview, right-click and go to Zoom, Pan, Rotate, and then to Rotate View, clicking and dragging to rotate. Use the Escape key to finish. The gizmo system in the bottom left corner shows how the reference axes are positioned based on the current point of view. By default, X and Z represent the ground plane, and Y represents depth. To change the convention, press the spacebar key to open the orientation window and switch from Y up view to Z up view. This places the ground plane on X and Y axes, and depth on Z. This does not change the planes already defined or the orientation of shapes already drawn. When drawing any 3D sketch, the 2D reference plane taken is shown through two red axes on the preview and represent a plane where the 2D object is placed. You can change the reference by pressing the Tab key, as it is also shown by the letters next to your cursor. Apply the 3D sketch with Ctrl and B, and then start a new and independent 3D sketch by enabling 3D sketch and drawing on the preview. You can also edit these 3D sketches as seen for the 2D ones. The only difference is that all tools and edits now work in 3 dimensions instead of 2. Now, let's see how to create 3D objects starting from these 2D and 3D sketches. Switch to the Features tab in the top left corner to find tools for drawing 3D objects, here called Features. First, enter any sketch layer and enable the Extruded tool to create a 3D object by extruding an existing 2D sketch selected as a section. Adjust the extrusion level directly on the preview or through the panel on the left. Right-click and go to OK to apply. The 3D object gets shadow and reflection effects and becomes an own layer containing the original sketch layer used to build it, even if this layer is made by several drawings. Enable the Revolved tool to revolve a section around an axis. For example, take this sketch as the section and this line as the axis direction. A preview of the revolved object will appear. If you like it, apply it by right-clicking and going to OK. You can also adjust the angle of rotation if you want the object to revolve only partially. Enable the Swept tool to create tubes or conductors by sweeping a section along a defined path. On the left, click within the blue area to select the section to use, and click within the pink area to choose the path to follow. Once you go to OK, the tube or conductor will be created. Make sure the path touches at least one point of the selection, otherwise the tool may not work correctly. Use the circular profile option on the left to apply a circular section with a defined diameter. With the Lofted tool, you can create a 3D object from two sections aligned. Enable the tool and click under Profiles to select the sketches to be used as sections. For example, this one as first, and this as second. Then, apply with OK. You can also move the green node to change the guide to use. To edit any 3D feature, select any face or contour to adjust extrusion or edit its shape. You can also enter inside its subcomponents to edit the original shape of any section or base used and therefore modify the 3D object derived from it. Use Ctrl and B to apply and update the feature. To adjust the appearance of your 3D objects, go to Display Style at the top and select the style you need. Use Apply Scene to change the lights and the environment. Before saving as a part project, make sure your 3D feature does not include spare sketches, especially those not contributing to a 3D component. To save the project, go to File and then Save As. This is saved in .prt or .sldprt format as a part component, such as a single object with its own material applied that must be combined with other parts. To put together these components, create a new assembly project by going to File, New, and choosing Assembly. From the left, under Part Assembly to Insert, select the part projects to import into the assembly project. For example, let's take this part project just saved first. This will also be taken as reference. You can add other parts by going to Insert Components in the top left corner, then going to Browse. For example, let's take this one. Save your assembly project by going to File and then Save As a .sldasm file. From the Feature Manager panel on the left, you can select any part to move or rotate it on the preview. The reference component cannot be edited. To edit any component again, select it, right-click, and go to Edit Part. When you finish, apply your modifications by using the button in the top right corner to return to the top level of the assembly project. You can also right-click on any component and go to Appearances to apply a specific material. Adjusting opacity, reflection, and color properties. Each component will have its own material, ignoring single sketches if present. Thank you all so much for watching this video. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our website to discover more about SolidWorks, other CAD software, and how artificial intelligence is shaping design and engineering workflows.